Good morning students, this is 11th standard botany video class, video 4. In this video, we are going to continue the lesson, transport in plants. Dear students, in the previous video class, we have seen osmosis and different types of osmosis such as endosmosis and exosmosis, different experiment which are proving the osmosis process, that is Thistle Funnel experiment and potato osmoscope. Then we have seen plasmolysis, that means shrinkage of plasma membrane or cell membrane due to the lack of water due to exosmosis. That process is called plasmolysis. The reversible action of plasmolysis is deplasmolysis. That means water molecules are enter into the cell through semipermeable membrane by a process is known as endosmosis. According to this process, the cell content along with the cell membrane retain their original position. That process is called deplasmolysis. Then we have seen different types of plasmolysis: incipient plasmolysis, evident plasmolysis and final plasmolysis. Up to this only we have seen in the previous video class. Now we are going to see next topic, ascent of sap and their important theories in this video. The next topic is ascent of sap. Dear students, roots which are absorbing the water and mineral salts from the soil, which is transported to the other parts of a plant body by a vascular tissue, is known as xylem. The xylem, which are act as a super highway of water conduction. So this xylem, which are conduct the water and dissolved mineral salts in a upward direction to different parts of the plant body. So the water which is present in the soil along with dissolved minerals is absorbed by the root as and transported through the xylem to different parts of the body is known as ascent of sap. And also the transport of water and mineral salts is taken place only in the upward direction, not in the downward direction, upward direction. That process is known as ascent of sap. The water with the dissolved minerals is called sap. So this is said to be sap and ascent of sap. Dear students, see the diagram. This is the experiment which has demonstrated the ascent of sap. That means the xylem tissue alone conducting the water and mineral salts in an upward direction. That process is called ascent of sap. So for that, we have to take the balsam plant, in Tamil it is known as Kasi Thumbai Chedi, and a beaker containing the red color solution named eosin. Then after that, a twig of a balsam plant is dipped into a beaker containing eosin solution and kept the apparatus for few hours. After few hours, a streak of red color which is appeared in the stem of a balsam plant. Remove the plant from the beaker and then by using a knife or a blade, we have to take a thin section of a balsam stem and place it under the microscope and observe it. The thin section of a balsam stem showing the vascular bundles, that means xylem and phloem. In this vascular bundle, xylem indicates the red color. The phloem, which is white in color, indicates xylem alone conducts the water and mineral salts in the upward direction to different parts of the body. That process is known as ascent of sap. See the diagram. This is the vascular bundle which we are keeping under the microscope, cross section of a balsam stem. The xylem bundles are shown in the red color. The phloem, which are in the light blue color, indicates ascent of sap process by xylem elements. Dear students, the path of ascent of sap. So dear students, water travels up in the upward direction with the help of vascular tissue. There are two types of vascular tissue, xylem and phloem. Xylem conducts only the water and mineral salts in the upward direction. The other one, phloem, which are conducting only the food material prepared in the leafy region to different parts of the body. So for this, we have to take a branch of balsam plant placed in a beaker containing red color dye or eosin solution. After some time, the red streak means pattern, appears on the stem, indicating the ascent of water is taken place. Remove the plant from the water and cut a transverse section of a stem and place it on the microscope and observe it. Only the xylem elements are showing the colored portion, which indicates the path of water transmission is taken place with the help of xylem alone. The phloem is not colored, indicating that it has no role in the ascent of sap. So that is the balsam plant experiment, which proves the ascent of sap. Next, mechanism of ascent of sap. Dear students, it is a big challenge how the xylem elements, which are transporting water and dissolved minerals from a small plant to a tall trees. For this, number of theories has been put forward by different scientists to explain the mechanism of ascent of sap. The first theory is vital force theory, root pressure theory, and physical force theory. The first we are going to see vital force theory. According to this theory, xylem is mandatory, that means xylem is essential for the ascent of sap process. This theory contains two theories. One is the relay pump theory by Golsky in the year 1884 and the pulsation theory of J.C. Bose in the year 1923. So first one, relay pump theory. The different changes, that means periodical changes at regular interval, that means regular intervals, the changes occur in the osmotic pressure of living cells of the xylem, parenchyma and medullary ray act as a pump for the movement of water. So that means this theory proves that the xylem, parenchyma and medullary ray, which are act as a pump to transport the water and mineral salts from one region to other parts of your body. That theory is known as relay pump theory. Next one, pulsation theory. So for this, J.C. Bose invented an instrument is known as crescograph. This crescograph consists of electric probe connected to a galvanometer. When the probe is into the inner cortex of the stem, the galvanometer showed high electric activity. That means the probe which is entered into the, that means connected into the inner side of the cortex of the stem, that means cortical region of the stem, the galvanometer shows high electrical activity. So for this action, Bose believed that the rhythmic pulsating movement of inner cortex like a pump. That means the rhythmic pulsating movements means it is similar to the heartbeat of our body. So it is similar to the heart beating of the human beings or other animals, which is similar to the rhythmic pulsation movement of the inner cortex like a pump, is responsible for the ascent up sap process. Finally, he concluded that the cells which are connected to the xylem exhibit the pumping action, that means like a heartbeat, and pumps the sap. Sap means what is it when? Water with the mineral salts, laterally into the xylem cells. That is said to be pulsation theory by J.C. Bose. Dear students, see the diagram. This is the scientist named J.C. Bose, who has invented the instrument is known as crescograph to find out the movement of water and mineral salts through the xylem. This vital force theory, which are showing certain objections. The first objection was put forward by Strasburger in the year 1889 and Overton in the year 1911. Both of them are experimentally proved that the living cells are not mandatory for the ascent of sap. That means the living cells are not necessary or not compulsory for the process of ascent of sap. For this thought, he selected an old oak tree trunk which is immersed in the picric acid and subjected to excessive heat killed all the living cells of the trunk. So this trunk, when dipped into the water, the ascent of sap took place. That means he has taken the old oak tree trunk, marakatta, okay, and immersed in the picric acid. That means he placed in the picric acid and he subjected to the excessive heat killed living cells of the trunk. Why are you placing in the picric acid? It is a acid. When you are placing the wooden block, it makes the living things to kill. Now the wooden block is contains dead cells. After that, this trunk is placed in a water which are showing the ascent of sap movements. So this is the first objection proved by Strasburger and Overton. Then another objection is pumping action of living cell should be in between two xylem elements and not on the lateral sides. That means the another objection is the xylem which are transporting the water and mineral salts in upward direction, that means it will be pumping the That means pumping action of a xylem elements is taken place between the two xylem elements, not in the lateral side of the xylem elements. That is known as another objection of vital force theories. Dear students, relay pump theory is an important 3-mark question. Write a short notes on pulsation theory by J.C. Bose is another important 3-mark question. Write the objectives of vital force theory is another 3-mark. Totally explain the different theory and their objectives of vital force theory is the 5-mark question. Kindly make a note on your textbook. So next one is the root pressure theory. Dear students, we have to take a plant which is watered by a person in a well manner, and that plant is taken for a few inches above the ground level. When you cut the plant at the ground level, your water and minerals are present inside of the plant, which exuded outside. That means it comes out of the cut portion. This is called sap exudation or bleeding. Sap exudation or bleeding means, for example, if a finger is cut with a blade or a scissor or any kind of sharp instrument, the blood is oozes outside, isn't it? That is known as bleeding. Likewise, if you are taking the plant above the ground level by using the blade or a knife, if you make a cut on the stem portion, from that cut portion itself the watery substances oozes outside, that means exude outside. That sap is known as sap exudation or bleeding. Stephen Hales, a scientist known as father of plant physiology, kindly make a note for 1-mark question. Dash was the father of plant physiology. Answer is Stephen Hales observed this phenomenon and coined the term root pressure theory. The another scientist, Stoking, in the year 1956, the root pressure as a pressure developing in the tracheary elements of the xylem as a result of metabolic activities of the root. So according to Stoking, root pressure means a pressure developing in the xylem tracheids as a result of metabolic activities of the root. So in the root region, some metabolic activities are taken place. Due to this metabolic activities, a pressure which is occur in the xylem tracheary elements, that means xylem tracheids is one of the xylem components. In that xylem tracheary elements is known as root pressure. But some of the objection is also raised against the root pressure theory. First one, this root pressure is totally absent in the gymnosperm. Not only that, some of the tall plants is also not showing the root pressure. Another one, there is no relationship between ascent of sap and root pressure. For example, in summer season, the rate of the ascent of sap is more due to transpiration, but at that time root pressure is very low. On the other hand, in winter season, ascent of sap is very low, but root pressure is very high. So there is no relationship between ascent of sap and root pressure. So this is the objection of root pressure theory. So first theory, root pressure is not happening in the gymnosperm plant. Not only that, in some of the tallest plant also not showing root pressure. This is the first objection. Second one, there is no relationship between ascent of sap and root pressure. For example, in the summer season, ascent of sap is high due to the transpiration, but root pressure is low. On the other hand, in winter season, ascent of sap is very low, but root pressure is high. So this is the objection of root pressure theory. Dear students, like vital force theory, root pressure theory is also important 5-mark question. Kindly make a note in your textbook. Next theory is physical force theory. Physical force theory suggests that ascent of sap is taken place through the dead xylem vessel, and the mechanism is entirely physical and living cells are not involved. The vital force theory, they insist that living cell is mandatory, that means necessary for the ascent of sap process. But this physical force theory state that ascent of sap taken place through the dead cells of xylem vessels, and the mechanism is entirely physical force only. It is not based on the living cell. So this physical force theory divided into different types. First one is the capillary theory. This was suggested by Boehm in the year 1809. He state that xylem vessels are worked as a capillary tube. This capillarity of the xylem vessel under normal atmospheric pressure is responsible for ascent of sap. He stated that the xylem vessels are act as a capillary tube. This capillary tube like xylem vessels, which are absorb the water and mineral salts at normal atmospheric pressure. This theory was rejected because magnitude of capillary pores can raise water level only up to certain height, but the xylem vessels are broader than the tracheid, which actually conducts more water and against the capillary theory. So dear students, this is the objection of capillary theory. So the magnitude of the capillary forces can raise the water up to certain height only, but the xylem vessels are broader than the xylem tracheids, so they are actually conduct more water and against the capillary theory. This is known as capillary theory. Is the another important 3-mark question. The second physical force theory is imbibition theory. Was first proposed by Unger in the year 1876 and supported by Sachs in the year 1878. This theory states that the water is imbibed through the cell wall material and not by the lumen. Underline the word. The watery substance or cell sap which are imbibed through the cell wall material, not by the lumen. But this theory is rejected based on the ringing experiment, which proved that water moves through the lumen of the xylem vessels and not by a cell wall. So this theory is known as imbibition theory, stated by Unger, supported by Sachs in the year 78. Next one is the cohesion tension or cohesion and a transpiration pull theory. This was originally proposed by Dixon and Jolly in the year 1894 and forward by Dixon in the year 1914 and 1924. So this theory based on the following feature. The first feature is strong cohesive force or tensile strength of water. The water molecules have the strong mutual force of attraction is called cohesive force. Dear students, what is cohesion? You studied in the 10th standard. The attraction of a force between the water molecules is known as cohesion. So this water molecules which are showing the strong force of attraction or cohesive force, due to which this water molecules are cannot be easily separated from one another. That means water molecules which are having the attraction due to the strong mutual force of attraction is known as cohesion. So these water molecules are cannot be separated easily. Further, the attraction between the water molecules and the wall of the xylem elements is addition. That means between the water molecules the attraction is taken place, means that is cohesive. Addition means attraction of water molecules and the wall of the xylem is known as addition. This cohesive and adhesive forces works together to form an unbroken continuous water column in the xylem. So this magnitude of the cohesive force is much high, that is 350 atmosphere, and is more than enough to ascend of sap in the tallest trees. So that is the first feature of cohesion tension theory, that is strong cohesive force which is taken place between the water molecule, that is the cohesive. The attraction is taken place between the water molecule and the wall of the xylem vessel is known as adhesive. The combined form of cohesive and adhesive, which are forming the magnitude between the cohesive force, is much high, up to 350 atmosphere, and is more than enough to transport the water and mineral salts or ascent of sap in the tallest trees. This is the first feature of cohesion addition theory. The second feature of this cohesion addition theory is continuity of the water column in the plant. Dear students, the important factor which breaks the continuity of the water conduction is known as air bubble in the xylem. So a formation of gas bubble or air bubble expanding and displacing the water within the xylem elements is called cavitation or embolism. Dear students, it's a very very important 2-mark question. What is embolism? Embolism means a gas bubble which are produced in the or introduced in the xylem elements expanding and displacing the water within the xylem elements is called cavitation or embolism. However, the overall continuity of the water column remains undisturbed since water diffuses into the adjacent xylem elements for continuing the ascent of sap. So even though a gas bubble is introduced in the xylem elements to expand and displacing the water within the xylem elements, they are changing the direction of a water conduction in the xylem elements, is called embolism or cavitation. But the overall continuity of the water is not disturbed, because the water diffuses into the adjacent xylem elements and the continuity of the water is taken place, which is proving the ascent of sap. So this feature is called continuity of the water column in the xylem elements of plant. The third feature of the cohesion tension theory is transpiration pull or tension in the unbroken water column. So the unbroken water column from leaf to the root is just like a rope. That means a water transaction taken place from the root region to the leafy region, which are act as a rope. If the rope is pulled at the top region, the entire rope will be moved upward direction. For example, a person which is standing on the top of the hill and they are pulling the rope from the bottom to the top. The person which are pulling the top, the rope will be moved in the upward direction. Likewise, the pull which is generated by the process of transpiration is known as transpiration pull. What is transpiration pull? Is an important 2-mark question. That means in plants, a pull is generated by the process of transpiration, which is known as transpiration pull. Dear students, it will be very easy to write the answer. The question itself, the answer is there. A pull which is occur in the plants due to transpiration process is known as transpiration pull. Due to transpiration, the water vapor evaporates from the mesophyll cell to the intercellular spaces near stomata as a result of active transpiration. Dear students, in the lower class itself you have studied what is transpiration. Excess of water will be removed through the aerial parts of a leaf which are containing the minute pore is known as stomata. That process is known as transpiration. So here the water which are evaporated in the form of water vapor from mesophyll cell to the intercellular spaces, that means a gap between the cells near the stomata as a result of active transpiration. Then after that, this water vapor which is present near the stomata transpired through the stomatal pore. Now, the loss of water in the mesophyll cell, which creates the water potential, that water potential is decreases. So the water is moves as a pull from a cell to cell along the water potential gradient. This tension generated at the top of the unbroken water column is transmitted downward from the petiole stem and finally reaches the root. So from the leaf to the stalk of a leaf, petiole, and then stem, and finally to the roots. This cohesion theory is mostly accepted among the plant physiologists today. So this transpiration tension theory is very, very important theory. Nowadays, this theory is accepted by all the plant physiologists. So this theory proves that certain tension is generated at the top of the leaf of the unbroken water column, reaches to the petiole, then stem, and finally reaches to the root. This cohesion theory is most accepted theory by all the plant physiologists. Dear students, up to this we have seen different theories which are proving the ascent of sap. I hope have you all understood what all the topics taught in the video. Remaining we will see in the next video class. God bless you. All the best, children.